The reason I gave to myself to reject the other two companies is that they tried to lowball me. Hey yo, what up? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. 我是 Xihao. So 今天呢, 因为 majority 的 selection 都是选 my job seeking experience. So 今天的 video 做关于我的 job seeking experience 啊. So first of all, I only started looking for job when I received my results and my letter of completion of studies. Before that, I was spending time working out at the gym, content creating like making YouTube videos, and I also spent time with my girlfriend and my family. The first platform I used was LinkedIn, just because I liked the interface. So I updated my LinkedIn profile, made it more professional than my previous profile. Then I just searched for jobs that I'm interested in and I'm capable of. At first, I was focusing on management trainee and machine learning staffs. I feel like I'm not the right person to tell you what is management trainee about because of my background. I chose to apply management trainee positions because it involves job rotations and I'm a person who likes to develop myself holistically. So I applied management trainee positions at various companies such as Advanced AI, RHB, Danone, and Green Packet. Unfortunately, I only got two replies, which are from RHB and Danone. So at first, RHB invited me to an online assessment and I proceeded to the second stage, which is a video assessment where I'm required to answer several questions in a certain time limit. After thinking for 30 seconds, I need to answer the questions. I thought I prepared quite well beforehand, but at the end, I didn't do well. I didn't speak well enough. I didn't speak fluent enough. So I didn't get any updates after that. The same thing happened to my Danone video interview. I got too nervous and I stuttered at times. So I never got any response again. So let's talk about machine learning. I'm very interested in the machine learning field and I think it's a trending and popular stuff nowadays. So I did apply a few positions such as data scientist and machine learning engineer. But due to lack of knowledge, I didn't really get any response. I didn't give up that easily, so I read through the job descriptions to know my missing skills and I enrolled courses on Udemy and Coursera to improve my competency. Currently, I finished two courses, one on SQL and one on self-taught programmer, where I learned Python and fundamentals of programming such as object-oriented programming, data structure, and algorithms. While I learned the online courses at home, I didn't stop applying for jobs. I move on by looking for jobs related to mechanical engineering. Just to make it clear, I'm actually a first class graduate in mechanical engineering from University Science of Malaysia. I did not apply to mechanical engineer because I do not want to work in a factory and I'm not interested in productions and manufacturing. However, 90% of mechanical engineering jobs in Malaysia work in a factory unless you want to become a sales engineer or a consulting engineer. A sales engineer has a higher starting salary, but since I want to become a professional engineer in the future, consulting engineer is a better choice for me. Despite the fact that consulting engineers have a lower salary and the salary growth is exponential, as LinkedIn doesn't provide much opportunities for mechanical engineer, especially in the consulting firm, I started using JobStreet and I had a book to look for M&E consulting companies in Malaysia. I searched online for their emails and maybe some websites to send in applications. Because of the previous bad experience, I did spend time to make my CV better in terms of the look and the content. Besides that, I also wrote cover letters to show that I'm really interested in working in the company. So I finally got my first interview. Although I prefer online interviews, the interview request was a face-to-face interview. So I went to the place, had an interview with the managing director, let's call it Company A. Due to the fact that I've experienced in consulting firms before, I didn't really face any difficulties answering the interview questions. I think I did quite well and I feel more confident after attending the interview. I got another job assessment after that. It is from a financial technology company. I applied for the junior software engineer role and the assessments include math, IQ, and programming. Personally, I think the questions are quite challenging, but very fortunately, I successfully completed it and I proceeded to the next stage, which is an interview with the software engineer in the company. I was nervous for this interview because I have no prior experience. I don't really understand what shall I do in this field. I told my interviewer that I'm really interested in this role and I'm willing to learn as fast as possible if I was selected. I did quite well, so I proceeded to the next interview, which is with the chief technical officer of the company. The things I said to him was very similar to what I said to the software engineer in the first round, where I convinced him that even though I have no experience, I'm still suitable for this role because of my passions and commitments. I told him that I do take online courses to build fundamentals and to be prepared for this role. When he asked me how would I describe myself, I said I'm a very bold person and I'm a fast learner. I'm bold enough to apply positions that are irrelevant to my background and I'm always ready for challenges. I think that is how I convinced him because I also received a job offer letter from them. The last interview I got was from a company, let's call it Company B, which did not announce any vacancies online. I didn't know they were hiring, I was just trying my luck because I found them on Google Maps and then I found their email and I just sent an email to them. I got an interview very last minute. The director of the company called me when I was having my lunch and we scheduled an interview later on the same day. Yes, you didn't hear it wrong. It's on the same day. It was a very spontaneous decision, but I still went to the interview because I didn't want to lose any opportunity. The decision was made also because CMECO is going to start on the next day. So I attended the interview, and to be very honest, I enjoyed speaking to the directors of the company as they are really patient and kind. The interview went very smoothly and I really hope that they offer me a job after the interview. Although it actually took me 1 hour to get back from the office to my home. Peak hour traffic jams are the worst. I would say that I'm a very lucky person as I got job offers from all three companies that I mentioned just now. Two roles as a mechanical engineer and one role as a software engineer. I really had a tough time to decide on which one shall I accept. I questioned myself, do I really want to switch paths? It took me some time to find information, to ask my friends and family, and to finally make a decision. So my final decision, I decided to go for the mechanical engineer position at Company B. The reason I gave to myself to reject the other two companies is that they tried to lowball me. What do you mean by lowball? They offered me a lesser amount than my minimum amount. Even though other people think that it's a small amount, but I think they didn't show enough respect and sincerity to me. When I think I don't get enough respect and sincerity, I will not work 100% for the company. This does not only harm them, but it also hurts me because I am the one who will restrict my own growth and development. So I just told myself it's okay to lose these opportunities. Advisors, although I'm not really experienced as I'm only job seeking for less than 2 months, I do understand that 2020 is a challenging year for everyone, especially for fresh graduates in 2020. I hope that everyone remains healthy and remains hopeful, even though you may feel tired and disappointed at times. It's fine, everything is going to get better. Don't lose hope when you face difficulties. Learn from your mistakes when you fail. Don't rush things and don't choose the job you don't like. Don't give up on applying and don't forget that you can learn additional knowledge and applying job at the same time. So that's all for this video and if you like this content, please like and share if you think it's helpful. Subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications. See you guys next time.